George. How are you? Congratulations.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I'm good. I'm very good. A bit bewildered. You know, it's you don't learn this at school. You know, they don't say you've got maths, then English, followed by Brit acceptance speech. You know, that doesn't happen. So I was a bit nervous. I'm still a bit shocked, but I'm happy.
I mean, it's about time, right? Your first album was massive. The second album blew up. I mean, I don't know. I was just like, oh, George Ezra's back. And then all of a sudden, it was every track is massive. I mean, how does that feel for you?
You don't... I don't know. It's surreal because when you're in the middle of it, you don't know that it's going on. And you can't plan for it. You've got no control over whether that's going to happen or not. And you're in this bizarre position where you just have to let happen what's going to happen. And then you have to work out in yourself how you're going to deal with that. And, you know, whether it goes well or not, you need to know, you know, how you're going to react to that. And yeah, I think all that I've learned is just go with it. And at the moment, I love it.
But how do you write these massive pop tunes? Like, you wrote Shotgun, right?
Yeah.
The most played, sung song. In my household, my son is 2 years old. He knows the words to Shotgun. He asked me to play Shotgun. I mean, it's moved to Baby Shark now.
Yeah, okay, good baby. Okay. I went to an aquarium in Chicago, and there was a family. The dad had Daddy Shark, the mum had Mummy. They all had T-shirts made up. And I don't often speak to people I don't know. I get quite nervous, but I had to go up and say, well done.
But they would have been, hang on a sec, you wrote Shotgun.
No, they were, they had no idea.
Okay.
No. I love pop music. I love hooks and I like, so when I'm writing music, sometimes I try and do the cool thing and I try and write the po' face and it's just not as fun. I just don't find it as fun. And I think one day I will, I'm sure. But at the moment, I enjoy it. And I enjoy, you know, when we finish, so I write with a friend of mine called Joel. And me and Joel wrote Shotgun together. And you have that kind of classroom cheeky grin at each other going, this feels fun. But you don't know anything more than that. You don't go, oh, and this is going to do X, Y, and Z. And again, you can't worry yourself about that. It's just we loved it. And we still do.
Who's the most famous person that's sung Shotgun at you?
I don't know. I don't know that anybody famous has sung it to me.
But they're too cool.
Maybe, yeah.
What's the cutest moment? Like, for me, like, you know, when my son, he's barely talked, but he sings Shotgun. Is there cute moments there?
So, I have a family friend and their beautiful daughter, Evie. She's not even 2 years old. And they sent me a good luck video last night, which involved her sticking up her index fingers as thumbs up and falling over. And that was cute. So thank you, Evie.
So what's next now? We're still not through the second album. Are you thinking about the third album?
I am, but not in a... That shouldn't be a headline in any way, shape or form. It's just me playing around with ideas. I would rather not take as long on the third as I did the second, but I probably said that before the second, and just life happens and you've got to, you know, go with it. So hopefully I'll have something together sometime soon.
But do you wake up in the night with a catchy pop thing in your head and go, that's it?
Yeah. Well, you think you do. You wake up in the night and you record it. You wake up in the night, it's awful. Every time it's awful, but in your dream, it sounds incredible. I do. I record. My phone is full of extremely embarrassing. The best one is if you're walking down the street and something comes into your head, you pretend you're on your phone, but it's got the dictaphone on, and you're trying to talk up to the microphone. It never comes out. Yeah.
Was that how Shotgun was created?
No, not quite. Shotgun started with Joel played a synth line, and I just started singing the. It was that nursery rhyme, you know. I started singing that, and I started with the lyrics Shotgun. And I ended with someone. I didn't have the hot sun. and I was going, I can't sing this, Joel. I can't sing this. But it just felt natural, so we kept it.
I'm dying for the moment when I'm at a festival and you're on, because that will, for me, will be the biggest moment when the whole place.
The one thing I can say with confidence is, if you come to a festival we're playing, we play Shotgun, it will kick off. Because it does. And I've got no control over it. There's just something about people at a festival, it's good fun. Yeah.
100%. Congratulations, George.
Thank you. Have a good night.